Hello, I'm Doug, and this is the Taste and Sensibility Channel, and here we are today on One Bourbon, One Scotch, and One Beer, number 3. So this is a little feature that I do in between my bigger, longer series. So we just finished up with fresh cheeses, and we're about to move into coffee. But I do these just to catch you up on what I'm drinking in the bourbon world, in the scotch world, in the beer world. Because I'm always testing and tasting things, and these are the things that caught my attention most recently and snagged me by the taste buds and made me stop and look and wonder and appreciate them a lot. So here we have I.W. Harper 15-year-old bourbon. We have Kalila 17-year-old unpeated Scotch whiskey. And here we have Elysian's Space Dust, which is an IPA beer. So if you like the things that you've been seeing on this channel, sometimes they're reviews, sometimes they're just mumbling, then please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, click that bell to get notified, leave a comment down below, leave a question. I have lots of questions. I'm always wondering about something. So I think we're ready to dive in here. I don't see this stuff normally, but I found it on a recent trip to Texas, and I guess I have it because of probably live streams on YouTube. Where the more experienced, just my guess based on their comments and how interacting they are with other seemingly experienced commenters on the live streams. And at the time when everyone's chiming in with what they're drinking that night, I see lots of comments that they are drinking I.W. Harper 15. So when I saw it on a shelf on a recent trip to Texas for only $66, I said, yeah, I'm gonna get that one. Because these guys, nice pop, if that matters, in the least. So YouTubers always doing that. So there's a nice size pour. This is 43% ABV or 86 proof, and I'm looking for a source. I.W. Harper Distilling Company in Tullahoma, Tennessee. So it doesn't have anything in the way of a mash bill, but it does have an age statement, aged 15 years. Kentucky Straight Bourbon Whiskey, 43 and 86, since 1872. Anywhere, anytime, it's always a pleasure. Well, I have enjoyed this bottle. It's in this very nice, fancy decanter-like bottle. Very understated labeling on the front and on the back, but it's classy looking. And I have enjoyed the whiskey. So that is a nice color. You don't get to add coloring to bourbon. So that must be the natural color. On the nose, it's saying caramely. I think I smell a few things indicating rye. But every time I say that, there's a little acetone smell. There's ethanol. I don't get a lot of wood, and I've had a couple grams today. I've had one scotch, I've had one bourbon. Bourbons, I've had some of this. So my palate's already warmed up, taste buds have been going some. But on the nose, I just don't pick up a whole lot. Caramely. I want to say cherry, but I know I don't taste cherry when I drink this stuff. It's older and the cask has kind of taken over. Less spirit driven, more cask driven. So yeah, the nose is not much there, but the taste is where I really enjoy this bottle. Wow, that's caramely. Caramely, honey. There's kind of a fruitiness to it. It's not very sweet. It's not sweet. The caramel notes are the brown parts, the cooked parts, the burnt parts, burnt sugar. There's a fruitiness, but it's ambiguous. It's a peach, it's a cherry, it's an apple. and faint in the background. The caramel, old wood, old leather, old library, dusty, musty stuff. But that's also faint. It's got some age to it, but the individual components don't poke out very far in any direction, so it's to make it identifiable. So this is nice, rounded, smoother, no edges, nothing sharp. So I just find it interesting that this 15-year-old bourbon is about the same age as the oldest single bottles of Knob Creek or Wild Turkey or some of the more well-known bourbons, and it's just pleasant. Maybe this is lower proof, but I'm just really enjoying this, and it's not too woody, it's not bitter. There's a slightly bitter finish, but it's not a big deal. It's not off-putting. Just let you know that it's older. Yep, caramel is the most identifiable thing I'm getting in the old things notes. Is it leather? Is it tobacco? Is it wood? Yeah, I think I'm identifying the wood tannins. They're not strong or in any way overpowering either. So I am just enjoying this. And really having a good time trying to identify it. I can't figure out why I like it so much, because the flavors aren't strong. They're not punching me in the face the way I usually like my whiskeys. So I'm liking this at the lower proof and the softer notes. And I'm not sure why. So that's fascinating to me. So I'm going to set this down so I don't knock it off on the top here. So, IW Harper, 15-year-old, straight Kentucky bourbon. Next, we are moving on to Scotland, and specifically the island of Islay. Islay is known and famous for peated whiskies, which are smoky, burnt, ashy. But I came across this one in a shop recently nearby. And said, wow, I've got to have this Kalila Islay single malt scotch whiskey. It's aged 17 years, unpeated style, natural cask strength. And this says 55.9% ABV, bottled in 2015 from Diageo. So it's a official bottling from Diageo. And the 17 year stuff is probably pretty rare. And the unpeated stuff is probably pretty rare, but when you taste Johnny Walker Black, say, the smokiness probably comes from Kalila. And Diageo has to have 35, 40 distilleries contributing to Johnny Walker Black, because those blends make up such a huge portion of the Scotch whiskey market. So I should be pouring this in and letting it air out a little bit, because 17 years has been kept up in a cask for a long time. Natural cork. Really nice label and presentation on it. And the cask strength is greatly appreciated. So when I get a Scotch whiskey that's cask strength like this high, 55.9, I'm usually going to put some water into it and let it open up. All the flavor and aroma components will become less soluble when I add the water, and they'll be up in my face and more available for me to enjoy. So I smell it, so it's malty, salty, and marine. I must always get all those marine notes on the Islay whiskeys that I drink. You don't even have to drink it, you can just smell it. Almost like a walk along a beach where things are walking and crawling and crawling out of the ocean and going back in. So that's iodine-ish and seaweed and crabs. foam. Okay, I don't smell foam, but you know what I mean. It's a whole experience. It smells salty. Smells oceany. So I'm going to taste that meat a couple times and then add some water to it. Whoa, it's a strong malty taste. And salty. It's like you're tasting salt, but I know sodium chloride does not distill over in this alcohol water vapor that is distilled and collected. But it sure tastes like salt. Like you just took a salt shaker and dumped it in. So that is malty and old and rounded. Also no edges, no sharp points poking into you. It is older, well-rounded, malty, but all those marine notes that you're used to from Islay. Oh, it's just so good. So here goes my water now. There's a little more flavor in there that you can unpack with a drop of water. I usually add a half a teaspoon to an ounce. Probably still have closer amounts in there. I'll give it a little time to open up and mix. So I love Kalila. The regular 12 is one of my go-to Islays because underneath all the peat and smoke and ash and stuff that you taste, it is sweet and fruity is what I taste in the 12-year-old. I'm not really getting fruits here. But that sweet barley sugar sweetness that's in there is just wonderful in the Kalila, and I don't get that on other Islay whiskeys, peated or not. So I just love Kalila for its uniqueness. And Kalila is actually probably the highest volume producer of Scotch whiskey on Islay. Diageo is big, and they need a big distillery to produce, and I think they're bigger than anybody else. But I haven't checked that fact recently. So with the water on the glass, it still tastes very malty. It smells very malty. Sweeter. More marine notes. Is it a fruity sweetness or malty cereal sweetness? I'm trying to decide. There's a lightness to it. The maltiness has smoothed out. It's a little less intense. Yeah, a little less intense, sweeter. Still can't decide whether there's any fruit notes in there at all. Even though I imagine them in the peated Kalila 12, I don't really think I'm getting the fruity stuff here. Maybe an apple peel? But it's faint and indistinct. But I am just enjoying this Kalila 17 unpeated so much. But this was about $150 to buy this bottle, $153. To buy this bottle in a store an hour away from my home. I'm close to New Orleans, and the whiskey selections aren't always great. I can get much more interesting stuff over in Texas. But I went to Baton Rouge to a pretty specialty whiskey liquor store, and they've got lots of stuff I don't see in the New Orleans area. So I found this there and went, boom. So I've been enjoying this and been fascinated by it, to taste Kalila without the peat, and an old Kalila without the peat. So I just love it. It's a great companion for my 12-year-old. Yeah, okay, I'll finish that later. And now we're ready for the beer in the lineup here, which is Elysian Space Dust IPA. I'm seeing a bunch of sediment at the bottom here. Yeah, let's just mix that all right in. If there's some yeasty goodness in here, I want to taste it all. And then I don't even know where this brewery is from. Brewed and bottled by Elysian Brewing Company, Seattle, Washington, Fort Collins, Colorado. Okay, so they have two locations, and they're close to some interesting barley growing areas and maybe some interesting hop growing areas. So now that I shook it all up, I'm gonna open this and have a nice big fizzy mess on my hands. Yeah, this is a delicate operation. So everything's rushing toward the top as the pressure's released. There we go. The operation was a success. And then we've got my Kabita green bottle opener. Run that down. And I will pour this into this cheap plastic glass. I got this for summer use outside in the patio and don't really have any other presentable glasses, but we'll go with this. Let's just pour this sucker in there. Yes, that's very presentable. Now I need to talk for 2 or 3 minutes while the phone dies down. So, I'm an IPA guy. I like IPAs, I like stouts, I like all kinds of beer, but I seem to be going back to IPAs more and more. When I get a choice in a grocery store and just picking a six pack for something, or go to a bar. There's lots of interesting craft breweries in the New Orleans area. And I really enjoy going around and tasting all their different wares. All their different offerings. So, yeah, there's certainly a bunch of haze in this guy. I wonder if I should try to drink the foam. It'll probably make me burp a lot, huh? Wow. Flowery and hoppy. Hops, 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 and then lots of floral notes. Maybe hops are a flower, I don't know. But there's lots of the grapefruit, lots of the hops notes, and most of those are floral type things. Interesting. Wow, very nice. Soft. Hoppy, bitter, grapefruity sort of thing. It's not one of those over-the-top kinds of grapefruit citrus note punch. It's just, it's a softer version of that. So I've had people give me bottles of this, and I've bought six packs from time to time at the grocery store, and I've always liked it. But I didn't know, I just thought it was an IPA. I thought it hit hard, and right now it's not hitting me so hard as a grapefruity, bitter, hoppy thing. So you certainly notice the hops, notice the IPA nature. It's just a lower level, it's a notch dialed down, which I can appreciate from time to time. I could probably even take it a notch lower than this and go, yeah, that's a good IPA. But it's, I'm not sure I can find any of the malt notes from the barley. Even though the hops are dialed down a notch, I think it's still covering up the nature of the beer. And I think I read this was 8.2% ABV, which is a pretty good punch, so yeah, don't drink it all. Don't drink it fast. Sip on it for a while. So this is so pleasant. Little bit yeasty, a little bit hoppy, and I'm still looking for malt notes, but the yeast and the hops are plenty for me. It's refreshing at refrigerator temperature, and it's been coming up for a while. The bottle was out maybe 10, 15 minutes before I opened it for the video. So this is good, I'm enjoying it. And it's a notch or two lighter on the hops than I remember or expected. So it's good to retaste things from time to time and taste them after other things. Taste them in a different order. Taste them before and after food. So this is a wonderful experience in my cheap plastic glass. So George Thorogood would approve of this. and this, and this. And I'm going to finish this off very slowly because of the 8% ABV. In here after these guys. So once again, if you like what you're seeing on this channel, give it a thumbs up and leave a comment, leave a question, subscribe, and click that bell to get notified. These videos usually come out on Mondays and Thursdays, and in between series, there's usually a little hiatus or a hiccup or something that keeps them from floating out on the same schedule. As I change modes, change sets, change scripts, change everything about it. But we'll get back on track for Mondays and Thursdays as we move into coffee. So I think that's about it for this one, so please come back next time for coffee and we'll all wake up together.